In the realm of consciousness studies, the nature of human awareness has been a subject of fascination and philosophical inquiry for centuries. Numerous theories have emerged, attempting to decipher the origins and mechanisms underlying consciousness. One such theory, proposed by renowned physicist Sir Roger Penrose, challenges conventional notions by suggesting that proto-consciousness is a fundamental aspect of the universe, existing independently of the brain. Here, we delve into Penrose's hypothesis and explore its implications for our understanding of consciousness and existence itself. Proto-consciousness, a primordial foundation. At the core of Penrose's theory lies the concept of proto-consciousness, a primordial state of brain organization that serves as a foundational building block for consciousness. Unlike traditional views that associate consciousness solely with the brain's complex neural network,
I mean, I think that consciousness is a fundamental feature in the sense that, in the scheme that Stuart Hameroff and I have developed, it's an integral part of the what one needs to make quantum mechanics make sense, if you like, the way that alternative things become other than superimposed, as quantum mechanics would say, one or the other happens. And in that process of one or the other happening, there is an element of proto-consciousness, we claim. So in that sense, proto-consciousness is fundamental to the universe. Now, in this view, the way that the laws of physics operate would require proto-consciousness.
Penrose postulates that proto-consciousness is an inherent property of the universe itself. This means that consciousness is not limited to human beings or even living organisms, but is an integral part of all existence. Implications for universal consciousness. Penrose's hypothesis takes a step further by proposing that the consciousness experienced by an individual in the present moment can have a profound impact on what he calls universal consciousness.
Now, it doesn't tell us that it's organized anywhere in the world enough to produce genuine consciousness, but if the world is, the universe is big enough and complicated enough, one might expect that, you know, here and there, would come about. But of course, you could imagine constants of nature adjusted in different ways so that it was so unlikely that it just wouldn't occur in a universe of the kind of size that we observe.
This notion challenges the boundary between individual consciousness and the broader fabric of reality. According to this view, the thoughts, emotions, and experiences of a person can ripple through the universal consciousness, shaping and influencing the interconnected web of awareness that spans the cosmos. Proto-consciousness and dreams, the cognitive unconscious. Drawing parallels between proto-consciousness and the cognitive unconscious, Penrose's theory also finds a connection within the realm of dreams. Dreams, often considered a window into the subconscious mind, reveal layers of thought and emotion that remain hidden during waking hours. Penrose suggests that the proto-consciousness experienced during dreams resembles the cognitive unconscious, hinting at the intricate relationship between conscious and unconscious states of mind. REM sleep dream proto-consciousness hypothesis. Another crucial facet of Penrose's hypothesis is the REM sleep dream proto-consciousness hypothesis. This proposition posits that the development and maintenance of waking consciousness are intricately linked to brain activation during sleep, particularly during the rapid eye movement, REM, phase. This perspective aligns with growing research that highlights the importance of sleep in consolidating memories, processing emotions, and nurturing cognitive functions. Independence of proto-consciousness from the brain. Perhaps the most intriguing aspect of Penrose's hypothesis is his assertion that proto-consciousness is not solely reliant on the brain for its existence. Rather, he proposes that this fundamental aspect of consciousness exists independently of the brain, challenging the conventional notion that consciousness emerges solely from neural processes. This view opens up a new perspective on the relationship between consciousness and the physical world, suggesting that the universe itself may possess a form of consciousness that transcends individual organisms. Conclusion. Sir Roger Penrose's theory of proto-consciousness as a fundamental aspect of the universe presents a radical departure from traditional views on consciousness. By suggesting that consciousness is not confined to the brain but is woven into the very fabric of existence, Penrose's hypothesis encourages us to rethink our understanding of awareness, interconnectedness, and the nature of reality. While the theory raises many questions and invites further exploration, its audacious ideas have undoubtedly left an indelible mark on the field of consciousness studies, sparking profound discussions about the true nature of our conscious experience and its place in the cosmos.